Hey guys, welcome back to TC's Gaming Channel. My name is King Najanok and I am back today with the man himself.
Hey guys.
So, a lot has been happening since the last episode.
Yep, quite a bit. For one thing, I haven't been on since the last episode, so well, actually there was that one excursion. I don't know. Have we published that episode yet with the where we were looking for the Ender Dragon spawn room?
Yes, we did. I recorded three episodes since then, but none of them ever were uploaded to YouTube, and I don't know what happened to them. I think I ended up deleting them.
Yeah, there's been. Well, I guess I have some explaining to do. So, at first, I don't remember what happened first. Did my computer crash?
Something like that, yeah.
Yeah, so since the last episode that we posted, my computer crashed and I didn't lose everything. However, it just for some reason it randomly disabled Skype. And it disabled Windows Media Player and a few other programs that used Microsoft, Microsoft programs. And so I was going to use a different computer for gaming and stuff like that, and it didn't turn out because I just didn't have time. And so then another computer of ours crashed, and this time it was the motherboard or something on the hardware end rather than the software end, which was my crash happened in the software end. And so we ended up getting a new computer, and so now I am able to play Minecraft with no lag. If you guys have seen the first episode, the first video I ever posted on YouTube, the I am TC3 I video, how laggy that was. That normally I can play without recording at 30 frames per second, but when I record, it looks like that. I can now record that game in 60 frames per second.
So pretty cool. So back and better than ever. So how about we figure out what we're gonna do today? I think we should
Well,
be showing them what we've been up to, even though we haven't been recording.
yeah, first, they don't even know about this ship.
Yeah, by the way, I apologize. I think I was talking a lot last night and I think I'm losing my voice, so if it sounds crackly and pretty disgruntled, sorry about that in advance. But yeah, got bored one day and I wanted to play a prank on TC, but then it turned into this. So I found a ship design on Google Images and basically decided, hey, I'm gonna replicate that the best I can and put my own little twists and turns on it on the interior, and then I used the technique Mumbo Jumbo used on his Mumbo Jumbaloon to build the rope bridge that leads up to it as well. So yeah. Just a nice little thing there, just hanging in the sky. I don't know if TC wants to keep it up there right by the base,
Oh, it
but
looks good.
well, look at that. Let's see. Okay, so I recorded the episode of me trying to build the tavern, but that was one of the ones that never aired. So let's go over and look at the tavern real quick. So, if any of you out there watch Jamsy Boy Minecraft, you will know he made a tutorial on a certain style of building. And so basically what I did was I took that style and turned it into a style that you could expand upon and make bigger buildings using the same kind of pattern. And so basically it's like two of the L-shaped houses side by side with a tower on top. Ow. You know what? You know what? Payback.
What?
Payback. Are we just gonna bow fight?
Yes, we are. Oh.
I'm warning you,
Unfortunately,
boy.
you have thorns on your armor and I
Yeah.
don't, so it's gonna hurt me every time I. Oh, wow.
Yeah, plus my
Yeah.
bow is like super OP.
Yep.
Yep,
Don't.
there
Yep.
we go. So my bow has punch 2, power 5, infinity 1. So that's why I can knock TC out so quickly, even though he's wearing like all that badass armor and stuff. But yeah, so this is the tavern. You can see it uses relatively the same blocks that Jamsy Boy used, but a little bit different, especially since I'm not inside the texture pack. But yeah, if we pop in here, I had to rebuild this thing like three times because it burnt down twice.
Yeah, I
Because of
noticed the
just
stone
this
roof.
one little bit of fire just caused so much trouble for me. But yeah, so when you're done, place all your empty bottles in here. I haven't really had any sales yet. But if you come up here to the top level, you can see For one diamond, you get three potions. I wish that I could move the beams or something, and so you can read that better. But yeah, so that's how it works. And there's some instructions here in case that's not clear enough, and some potions that are for sale. And I really need to make more. But yeah, so that's the tavern. Just a nice little project to the start of a town we can build over here or something. So yeah. Where'd you go?
I'm getting a diamond, as a matter of fact.
Where are you?
At my hole in the wall, I guess you can call it.
Your hole in the wall?
The cave.
Oh, okay, so you're down in the mines below your base?
No, I'm walking... Now I'm walking across the bridge. I'm heading towards the tavern so I could pay a diamond.
Oh, okay.
Be the first customer.
Sweet, thank you. I guess you like that free sample, huh?
Yeah, actually, I didn't take the free sample. Oh, yeah. I'm gonna save that for a rainy day.
Yeah, I gave free samples out to everybody on the server, so... Everybody got one.
Speaking of which, who's everybody?
Everybody is me, you, Zoe, Tristan, and my sister, technically, but she hasn't been on since we first started up the server. Let's see, when was the last time Tristan was on? Tristan built his house, and then he had internet problems, so he never got back on after that. But he's still trying to get back on, but we had problems ourselves, and so he couldn't have gotten on until TC and I figured out what our problems were, and got them figured out. So... Yeah, we left the place kind of broken, but we're fixing it up now, and so everything should fall into place soon enough.
Okay, I may or may not have dumped some stuff in the potion chest so I can claim my three potions.
Wait, what?
I may or may not have put some junk in the potion chest so I could take my potions because my inventory was full.
Oh, okay. Alright, so, let's see. I'm just gonna... Okay, yeah, there we go. Alright, so... Let us... Do I have any empty bottles on me? I do not. Okay. Alright, so, yeah, let's see. Let's apologize, because this episode is gonna be a lot longer than usual. We usually do something like 15 minutes. This one's probably gonna be more like a half hour or so. Because we're giving you a world tour today on everything we've done since we've stopped making videos.
And believe me, this is going to be one long world tour.
Yeah. Gotten a lot of stuff done. Mostly because I get on here about every other day since we basically stopped. I've gotten on like every other day and at least done something. Like built a little something or dug a little bit. You know, just put in a Netflix show and just dug out a massive hole or dug out the area for my base and whatnot. You know.
Hey, you know what you should do?
What?
You should, record whatever you're doing in between episodes and stuff and make that a montage, like it's so an inter-episode montage, and post that before we post a new episode or stuff like that.
Yeah, that actually would be a good idea. So yeah, let's pop into the spawn chunks, because it's closest, and show them what's been going on here.
Alright, sounds good. Take it away.
Okay, so, as you saw in the channel update 2 video, I think it was, the one where we told you why we had to stop recording for a little while, you could see in the background that we built Tango Tech's Iron Foundry. Now that took me roughly, I'm gonna say 9 hours to build, mostly because I messed up once and had to tear down the bottom part and rebuild it, but it's okay, and it worked for a long time, and I mean, I'm talking a couple of weeks, and we got so much iron. Unfortunately, that was... That didn't last as long as I hoped it would. Basically, what happened was, you know, computers. You have to turn them off every now and again, otherwise they get themselves burnt out. So, after a while, the server did have to close down, and I did have to unload the chunks, which meant the iron farm is now merged into one giant village, which means we get, like, one or two iron golems every couple of hours. So, it works, but it doesn't work as well as it does. You can see if I open up this chest... all these chests and hoppers are full, but that chest is where we hit our limit, and that's just in the ingots that we haven't converted to blocks. In blocks, this is the highest we've gone with blocks. You see these two chests are full.
So yeah,
it serves its purpose, it's still somewhat serving its purpose, and it's a necessity on pretty much any server. We need iron for a lot of stuff.
So I didn't want to interrupt you.
Yep.
But where's the way to the portal for the spawn chunks?
it was you passed it when we were getting when we were in the nether tunnel. Hang on a sec. Let's just catch up to where he is right now. That ender pearl did not work for some reason.
So maybe just lag.
Yeah, probably. Where are you? Oh, there you are. Over here.
Okay. So the ocean monument.
Yeah, it's down here. So the ocean monument, the farm there stopped working, mostly because all the guardians that were supposed to spawn inside the little cage that we built, they started spawning outside the monument instead in the water, and then they stopped spawning inside the cage. So that farm is broken, which means now I have to clear out all that water and actually do a bunch of work to build a legit farm. Because we need sea lanterns, and glowstone is suddenly now like dirt to a lot of people. It's just an ugly block, and sea lanterns are way better. And we need a lot of them. So I gotta build that sometime soon. Not looking forward to it, but we do need it, so yeah. Alright, so back to the tour. I don't think I showed this when I built it, but this is a tree farm inspired by the one Mumbo Jumbo built, but a little bit different. A little bit different design, a little bit different style, but same basic function. You grow your tree in the middle, chop it down, all the stuff lands in the hoppers and goes into this chest. Super, super simple. Over here, Exumavoy's latest farm, which I built a couple days ago. You can see it's starting to work, but the chickens haven't been laying eggs quite fast enough lately, so I need to increase the amount of chickens in that little compartment, and it should start working just fine. And let's see, what else is there? Oh yeah, so there's the sugarcane farm, the vine farm, the cactus farm, and the cocoa bean farm, all super, 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 super easy to build. Actually, they're not even legit farms, they're just where you grow stuff and harvest it. We had to take down the melon and pumpkin farm because I was trying to build the automatic potato and carrot farm, which ended up not working anyway. So one of these days, we gotta actually rebuild this. So yeah, for now, just let the contraption in the ground so I can remake it later. So speaking of the auto carrot and potato farm, this worked for about a couple of hours before they decided, hey, I want to join the village up in the sky, and they stopped sharing their loot with the villagers in the middle. So now they harvest all the stuff, but they keep it to themselves instead of throwing it down into the chest. So this is all we have left of the farm, and we should try and use it sparingly if we can. So yeah.
Yeah, I got a feeling chicken's gonna be becoming one of our main courses.
Yeah. Hang on a sec. And we're back. Okay. Back to recording. Okay, so sorry about that. My mom comes in without even knocking. It's a habit she needs to break soon. So this is our slime farm. This took me almost a week to make, digging out all the stuff and building it. Basically, the slime spawn on the little platforms down there. They jump off, and the iron golems down there kill them. A minecart and a hopper picks it up below the floor and puts it into an item elevator. You can see out the back here, and they all go into these chests in here. So really cool, really, really cool. We get we don't get as many as we used to. I don't know why. I think I need to dig it deeper now, because it only goes down to like Y50 or something. Or let's see, hang on. We're on 63, so that looks like about Y20 maybe at the most. So I need to dig that down even further if we want to get the rates to increase. But yeah, it works. We get slime blocks, we get slime balls, and yeah, you know. It works. Okay.
It works for now. Until another update breaks it.
Anything useful in here? Nope, that's just all the random stuff I got while building it.
Oh, lots of stone.
Yeah, anything I thought I had too much of, I just left in that chest. But, yeah, so that's the slime chunks. You can... Yeah, it's... I don't know what I was going to say there, but, yeah. So, basically... This is where we get a majority of our resources, but I can't wait to show you our next farm, because that's going to be epic. So I can't believe, actually, like, Hermitcraft and them haven't figured out yet that you can trade rotten flesh and get a ton of emeralds. I mean, seriously. Let's see, what's the type of villager that you trade for? It's
cleric.
The type of... Yeah, cleric, that's it. You can trade clerics rotten flesh. I think the cheapest you can do is like 36 rotten flesh for 1 emerald. So, which is awesome if you have either a pigment farm or a zombie farm. because rotten flesh was considered one of the most useless items in Minecraft. Now it has a better purpose. So basically, what we have here, this is not my design by the way, I copied this off a guy on YouTube, is we have a gold, gas tier, emerald, magma cream, and gunpowder farm, all in one. It's one farm that collects it all. Actually, I take it back. It doesn't collect the emeralds, but you trade the rotten flesh that you get from the pigmen for emeralds. It's really cool. That's so cool. I cannot believe that Hermitcraft and a bunch of other servers did not think to build something like this. Because it's not a farm for usefulness, but it's a farm if you want to get rich quick, you know?
Right.
So yeah, I'm going to pause the video here, and I will climb this tower and start recording when we get to the top.
This up here, actually, I never got to see.
We're back, baby. That's the AFK tower, remember?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so this is our farm. You can see we are way up above the nether. We use the nether trick where you grow the trees on the bedrock and blah, blah, blah. Everybody knows that trick, and if you don't, look it up, because it's a... You really do need that sort of thing if you want to build an efficient gold farm slash gas farm. So this is our farm, and hang on a sec. There we go. So you can see it's relatively simple looking. It's not as complex as you may have thought it was going to be, right? So basically how it works is you have the minecart that runs along these rails, picking up anything on the platform. And these hoppers here just make it so you don't pick up the swords and all the useless junk that you actually... Or it basically stops the hopper from filling up with useless stuff instead of getting all the good stuff. And so it runs along, and then it puts it into these chests here. And we've only been here about 10 minutes today, and it's already gotten all this gold. And a bit of rotten flesh, TC traded it for some emeralds. So, pretty darn efficient. I do say so myself. So yeah, basically, these are the two clerics that I managed to get up here after we got the villager breeder up and running. That one doesn't want to trade. This one wants to trade for emeralds. And you can see there's a bunch of other trades I've unlocked for both of them that allow us to basically trade for a bunch of awesome stuff. Now, the problem with the one flaw with this farm is you do have to keep the iron golems, their numbers up. Because basically, the magma cubes that spawn in here do attack the iron golems occasionally. So every now and again, you'll lose a few iron golems. And I think 6 hours... I think we ran the farm for like 6 hours on 10 golems, and it ran right up to the end. So you can see I put a bunch more in there just to see if we can get it to last a lot longer AFK-wise. Oh yeah, and if you want to run around on the inside and collect XP, you can. Just make sure there's no ghasts, because it'll destroy the glass. But yeah, pretty flippin' cool. And any excess trading of lapis goes into this chest, so we always have lapis to enchant stuff. So yeah, that's our farm.
Uh-huh.
I gotta get rid of these swords. Every now and again, it picks up a sword. So, not a big deal, but we got a bunch of golden swords that are pretty useless.
Well, I guess, yeah, this isn't modded Minecraft, because if we were playing Hexit, we could either uncraft them for gold or de-enchant. Well, I guess we can't disenchant them, because they fixed that bug.
Yeah. Speaking of modded, I got mod sauce to finally work. You can tell I'm a huge Hermitcraft guy, by the way, because I'm following like 10 of them. yeah. I finally got modded Minecraft to run, which means if we want to, we can try and set up a modded server and try and do modded Minecraft series as well. So let us know down in the comments if that's something you guys would at all be interested in. So let's also,
I have been told that I need to start doing mod reviews as well.
Yeah, I saw that comment. That's a good idea. You should do mod reviews, because I barely got AE2 to run. And apparently, when I first saw AE2, boy, did that flip me out. I thought it was going to take me, like, months to figure that stuff out. And it only took me, like, a couple weeks. But even still, that mod scared me so much. And now I think I've got the hang of it, kind of, mostly. I still can't do auto-crafting to save my life, but, you know. I'm getting there. I'm learning the mods, basically. So this is a quarry. This quarry took me... God, how long did it take me? Like, more than 2 weeks. It didn't take a month, I know that. But more than 2 weeks. All I did was set up a beacon down there with haste 2, and just dug away at this while listening to... Whoa. Bad.
Hey, I was trying to knock you away from the edge, not into it. Relax.
I know, but even still, you were trying to shoot me. Nope. Okay. So yeah, all I had to do was pop on Netflix or watch a TV show or something in the background while digging, and time just flew by. And before long, we got so much stone. Oh my god, I am...
Oh my god.
Dude. Where are you?
I died.
Yeah, I know, but where'd you spawn?
Well, the last place I slept.
Back at the base? Oops.
Yup. Back at the hole in the wall.
Alright, well, go ahead and meet me over at my castle. That's the next place I'm going to show. Because we need to show what happened to all that stone and all the resources we had in that giant hole. So basically, it's just a short walk from my castle. In fact, I was, before I set up the portals, I was walking back and forth to deliver all the stone back to my castle. So yeah, you can also tell I got a bunch of the nether tunnels done. You can see the chains that go all the way up to the nether ceiling. Really, really cool. And a couple of the portals that go off in each direction, I'm going to build more tunnels for and expand upon this network, this nether hub network. But in the meantime, I've got bigger stuff I got to finish first. I.e. my castle and the guardian farm. So yeah, so let's pop into my castle and you will see what 5 seasons of Archer, 3 seasons of Wolfblood, and countless movies has added up to. And it still isn't finished, not even close, but I've been doing a ton of work on this castle. A ton of work on the castle.
So also, go for it.
No, you go.
Also, if anybody wants to make us, on a side note, if anybody wants to make us a introduction or any type of animations that we would use in our for the introduction of our video before we start talking, feel free.
Yeah. So basically, you can tell, especially if you've seen our earlier videos of what this castle used to look like when we first started out. This took forever to do. Oh my god. So long, and it was just mindless digging. Just digging out all the dirt and all the stone, clearing out mountains, filling up ditches, drying up ponds. Oh man, did this take a lifetime to do. But in the end, I think it's worth it. I really, really do. So the castle bit itself, like the main 4 walls and the 2 entrance towers and the 4 towers that make up the walls, all that is all done. It's still hollow. I need to put like barracks and stuff on the inside and, you know, do the interior decorating, but the outside is done. And it's really, really cool. And I love the gate. I built the gate in one of the missing episodes, and oh man, that was actually the one that I actually wanted to upload. But without TC, it's just me droning on. And plus I had a cold that week, so I didn't sound my best and it didn't turn out what I'd like it to be. But yeah, basically, we have our courtyard here, which is just nothing but torches, but don't worry, this place will light up soon enough. And, and I still need a vote on this. I'm going to go ahead, I still need to set up a command block feature where you can't go into creative mode, but you can go into game mode 3, just for the purposes of recording. But I need your guys' opinion on something. Basically, in the 13th century, I can't remember what century this castle was based on, but in those times, they had these giant, they're like these stubby cone-shaped things on top of their towers that basically prevent cannonballs that were lobbed over from collapsing the entire tower. They would basically hit these cone things, and most of it would be, most of the impact would be, it'd be cushioned. And so it would do a lot less damage if they tried to lob cannonballs into the towers. But I just don't like how they look. I mean, these are historically accurate to how tall they would be. They were exactly... I have the paper right here. They were exactly... hang on. Yeah, they were exactly 1.5 meters taller than the outer wall of the tower. So basically, these little spikes that peak up, these little baselines right here, they were exactly 1.5 meters taller than that. And this is what they look like. I think it looks like a giant pile of turd right on top of my castle. And I want them gone. But I want to hear what you guys think. Because, quite frankly, I think I should say good riddance, get out of here, don't come back to these things. They are god-awful. But then again, I want to hear what you guys think about them. Should I try to redesign them? Should I try a different block type? What should I do? I want an opinion. Dude!
Did you know that there's a hole in the middle of one of your towers?
Yes, because the beacon's supposed to be down there. Is the beacon on? I need to go down there and check and see the beacon. No, there's no beacon down there. This is the underground part, by the way, where I've been doing a ton of digging and so much strip mining. You won't find a diamond down here for miles. Oh my god. I've done so much mining down here and so much clearing. You need to wait for, like, all that stuff has all been cleared out. And the mine mostly goes in that direction for the most part. But even still, oh man, we've got so many resources. I don't think we'll ever run out of anything. Let me pop back into game mode zero. So, getting back to the quarry, all that stone went into these chests here. All of it. So, let's see. These are 7 tall, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times 7 is 35, 36, 37, almost 38 full double chests of stone, just from that quarry. And that was the stone. Imagine all the resources that were in it, including all of the sandstone, all of the dirt, all of the other stuff, gravel, and all that. Basically, everything that I own is in all these chests, all organized up the best I could get it. And all the treasures from it all are in here. So you can see these are what's left for our sponges and prismarine, so not much. That's why we need the farm. Gas tiers are free, by the way. So if ever you get on the server and you need gas tiers, take them. They're yours. I don't want them. We get so many from that farm. Basically, my iron supply. I've been trying to get chainmail armor, too, because I really want chainmail armor for some reason. But it's a rare drop. Anyway, redstone, lapis, quartz, emeralds, obsidian, diamonds, gold, slime, coal, you get the idea. So many resources, all from that one giant quarry. And it was totally worth it. Dude! Shot by a random NPC. Did you shoot yourself?
I didn't shoot myself. How could I have shot myself?
I don't know. What does that mean?
It didn't work properly.
I never saw that message before.
That didn't work properly. Honestly, I messed that up. So what I did was I typed in /me. You can tell by that little X, that star next to it,
yeah,
that it's different from a normal. And that's what it was supposed to look like.
Mm-hmm.
But instead of putting it like that, I accidentally put my name twice.
I see.
The /me automatically puts your name, and then I put my name after it, forgetting that.
Yeah. Anyway, so if you want to see the full scale of the entire project, this is it. See that little blue dot? That's a beacon. So if that's one block, imagine all of this being cleared out. And it just took forever. But I love it. I really love it. And there's no going back now anyway. You can't just undo all of that. Look at this. This huge mountainside that just had to be cleared out over meow. All of that just had to get gone, and it's gone, and I am tired, and there's still so much I gotta do. But it's gonna be totally worth it when I have the most badass castle ever. So yeah, that's just my base, and now I'm starting to gloat, and now I'm feeling like a jerk. So why don't we go back to touring the world instead of my own personal expertise? Whatever. Anyway, where did you end up respawning?
I'm at Zoe's house.
Oh, okay, yeah. So, basically, Zoe and Tristan both started working on houses. Tristan built something super, super simple with all the stuff in his inventory, and I basically helped him with my looting pick to go get diamonds for him. So he's got a few diamonds, he's got resources, he can handle himself, I think. I mean, the guy's still kind of a noob, but, you know, he's my friend. I try to help him. So yeah, so I guess next on the agenda would be to slay the Ender Dragon, since we got the server back up and running and we're recording episodes again. By the way, that leads to the Mesa biome, but I'm not going to go down there, because it's a long run. So yeah, I think that's mostly everything. I mean, you know, you've already been to the Guardian Farm, we did those in previous episodes, and the area where we collect Nether Skulls, I really just half-slabbed it. I mean, I was so sick and tired of running around in circles, hoping a skeleton would spawn, and then deciding, you know what, I'm just going to half-slab this area, so they will spawn. So yeah, big amount of area, just half-slabbed. Didn't take too long, I just took out one of the big towers of the fortress and used all the slabs to to cover the area, so more stuff would spawn in the actual fortress instead of out in the wilderness of the Nether. So, yeah. I mean, that's pretty much it. That's all I've been doing for the past... How many months has it been since we stopped recording? Like 4 months or so?
Something like that. I think it was more like a month and a half, though.
Really?
No, actually, the last time I looked at the timestamp on the YouTube video was 2 months, so it's like 4 months.
Oh, okay, so...
Since the last time we uploaded.
So, yeah. Basically, been hard at work. And there's still so much we gotta do. So, yeah. It's been crazy. It's been going. Why are you hitting me? I never attacked you! Leave me alone! I never attacked you. No, leave me alone!
Zombie Pigmen.
I wish they could program them to tell the difference between an accidental attack and a deliberate attack. Because that would make our lives so much easier.
Yes, but how can you tell if it was accidental or deliberate? How would you define that?
I don't know. There's got to be some sort of line of code that basically defines whether or not you were attacking another NPC, or if another NPC was attacking you at the time. I mean, it would still be flawed, but at least they wouldn't just randomly attack you when you didn't mean to attack them. You know.
Right.
A guy can dream.
Right. So, yeah. I think that's about it.
That's it. That's pretty much everything. Whoa, Blaze. Bad Blaze. I need to get my helmet on, too.
Oh, yeah, I don't have my helmet on either.
Okay.
I didn't make a helmet. No, sorry.
There we go. All right, so let's figure out. I think we're already 20 minutes into an episode right now, so... If we're going to do something, let's do it. Otherwise, we could probably end it here.
Well.
And I think that's going to be where we're going to end it off today, because I got to go eat dinner, but we're going to record another episode right after this one. So yeah.
At least we should. My dad might have to get on the computer, because after all, I am using his computer.
Oh, okay. So yeah. So thank you very much for watching our episode today. I hope you enjoyed our nice little world tour of what we've been up to the past few months while we've been taking a break from YouTube, but we're back. We're back, baby. We're back.
Yep.
And we're better than ever, you know? I don't know what I'm saying. I am so tired. And I am losing my voice. Yeah. So, if you want to take us out.
All right. Like, subscribe, comment, all that YouTube-y stuff, and, well, have a fantastic day.
Yeah. Everybody out there, you're awesome. And you should know it. So have a great day, guys. We'll see you in the next time. All right, bye.
Bye-bye.